time. Ready? Ready? Let's go fight!
Not convinced they're going to be on their feet for very long.
Shalorus is definitely much more compact, carries that weight.
He's looking to unload the big right hand. Kamal hasn't thrown it yet, but he's clenching his fist and drawing it back.
This is a difficult task for Ariel Sexton because his strength is jiu-jitsu. But you need to be able to get your opponents into the ground, and ideally, you want to be on top.
Oh, caught him with quick hands, and he's got noticeably quicker hands. Not that he's super speedy, but Kamal is a little bit pedestrian with his hands there, and the punches are a little telegraphed too, although that overhand right was a bit snappy.
Like I was saying, Ariel needs to be able to find a way to really exploit his jiu-jitsu and get the Iranian national champion, Kamal Shalorus, on the ground. I'm not saying that that can't be done. There's guys that come into mixed martial arts with very little wrestling experience, like GSP, and he's just one of the best wrestlers out there in the MMA world. But it's a difficult task. It's a deep double leg. It's a great flare double leg by Kamal Shalorus. We get to see some of the BJJ off of Ariel Sexton's back here. Now, Ariel Sexton's keeping an open guard, which is very odd. Usually you want to put your feet either on the guy's hips in butterfly guard, which would be your hooks inside like that. That's butterfly guard right there, and you're working an elevator sweep. Or you want to close your legs around your opponent so that you don't have that extra space and kind of use your legs to pull him in and extend him away as need be.
Well, they're heavy hands that Kamal has. They may lack a bit of snap from time to time. He's got an odd... odd way of throwing those punches, Sexton. He leads with the right hand very often, which you don't usually see for an orthodox stance.
When he's coming forward with those punches too, that gives Kamal Shalorus the ability to duck under and really get deep penetration on that double leg. So he's got to be careful that if Shalorus just keeps timing that when Ariel's coming in with those 1-2 punches.
I think Kamal's cut, Jason. I think maybe not. Perhaps I'm mistaken. Thought I saw some blood over the right eye there, but just looking above us here, I don't think that's the case. Kamal getting caught there. It really is quite an odd style he's got.
Well, it's a weird pawing style. Whoa. That Ariel Sexton throws too. He doesn't really have a tremendous amount of power behind his punches. He's kind of throwing them out there. He's also switching his base from southpaw to orthodox. Again, this is really odd to see that Ariel Sexton's choosing not to close his guard. This gives Kamal Shalorus a bunch of options as far as making it easier to pass. He's trying to work his feet inside from the butterfly. See, like just like that, you have an open guard there. All he has to do is just step over.
Final minute of the first round.
Gotta be careful here because Ariel can up kick right to the face, and Kamar can also kick a downed opponent.
Ariel also just pushing out that right leg below the knee of Kamal, which could cause quite an injury there. Overextend the knee, hyperextend the knee. Second time he's tried that flying knee. Didn't quite work, and that's the end of a very intriguing first round.
We had Kamal with a nice flare double leg. It's in nice and deep. It's good penetration on those shots. And then just missed with that knee.
It wasn't far off, though. Costa Rican, that range-finding jab that doesn't.
You see Ariel Sexton switching up his.
He switches, doesn't he?
Yeah.
And that's why he gets drawn into leading with that right hand, which looks clumsy.
Yeah, he's leaving his hands out there too. Watch when he throws the punches. He leaves them out there, or he brings them back to his hip. He doesn't bring his hands back to his jaw.
Right.
See?
So open for the counter.
Out and hip, just like that. He's open to that right hand down the pipe. It just shows he's not really committed to throwing a bunch of strikes.
Well, there's that freaky looking lead right hand that landed.
And you say, look at the total strike thrown here. Ariel Sexton, 35 strikes. Shalorus, a little bit more busy with 44. Either fighter having
good left hand from
Shalorus. Ton of appreciable damage yet, though.
That's that lead right again.
That's a nice takedown.
Switching stance that frequently means you often stand square on, which can expose you as well.
And if you look at all the strikes landed now, Ariel Sexton 12, Shalorus 25. Much more difference in terms of actual strikes being landed.
More than double.
You see the right, or the left knee, I'm sorry, of Shalorus there swelling up a little bit. That's from a couple of the tie kicks that Ariel Sexton landed, and he was also, when he was on his back, Stevie pointed out, was kicking towards the knee joint.
Let's watch for that again. There it is, just below the knee.
Ooh, 8-1 right down the pipe. Not a lot of penetration on that shot.
Whoa, that one. Oh, oh, there's that to the head, knee. Yeah.
It looks like Shalorus is getting a little bit tired here. That last shot, there wasn't a lot of penetration and burst. Just like, you see there, he always giving up his back now. This could be dangerous. Oh, that looks like it's not quite under the chin, yeah. But you do not want a jiu-jitsu black belt on your back.
Manages to swivel around. May end up taking Ariel's back, not quite. Right above us here at cage side. Knee to the midriff.
See
Ariel, from
Ariel. Sexton. See Ariel Sexton was holding the wrist there of Kamal Shalorus.
Oh, sure, good punches from those, Ariel.
Those hands locked. Oh, nice kick. Kamar is definitely slowing down here. His takedowns aren't quite as crisp and as explosive as they were in the first round.
Still well over a minute and a half to go in this second round. It's a long road ahead.
It takes so much out of you when you're changing level, shooting for those takedowns, because you have to use your legs thrusting forward, your body, your hips, to manipulate another man's body. Sexton keep his hands exceptionally
very low, yeah, and he's almost leading with his face at times when he gets into that crouch position.
And if you look at the takedown so far, Ariel Sexton zip. Pushed right off of mount there. Ariel Sexton loading up that shot from his hip.
Takes a knee to the head, having tried to cling on to Ariel's legs. Paid for it. Running out of time in this second round for either man to make a big impact. 5 more minutes to come. And these two boys are tired.
See here, that one knee that Ariel Sexton landed was right on the noggin. And then he did have a microsecond to start to work for that choke.
Ariel Sexton looks as if he's about to race out. He didn't. He sort of just.
And you see how Ariel Sexton is really kind of hunched over. That's, I'm assuming, on purpose because he knows that Kamal is going to look for those takedowns and he's trying to make his body a little more compact. Nice. See, I always find that a little crazy when you do something that works. Like Ariel Sexton just connected with a nice kick right to the thigh. Keep doing it.
Sure.
Why change? If he doesn't have an answer for it, don't give him a different question.
He's taking a few punches now, and this is disorienting him. And if he can just land one solid blow, you feel there could be a big difference here. But Kamal did well. He went down, grabbed the leg, try and take a bit of pressure off the punches to the head. And probably bought him a little bit of time to clear his head there. And a referee, Olivier Coste, is making sure.
And if we look at the strikes landed so far through the fight, Ariel Sexton, 25, closing the gap on Kamal Shalorus, who has 32.
Well, that's interesting.
Good knee to the midsection there by Ariel Sexton. And those body shots really take the wind out of you. You know, the knockout shots that come into the face are the highlight reel ones, but tactically, brilliant to really work the body. Start disrupting your opponent's wind. There's that double leg, but didn't quite finish it. Yeah, you can tell that Kamal Shalorus is really tired.
Yeah, he really is.
When Ariel Sexton's coming forward with punches. Oh. That shot is kind of a Hail Mary. He just wants to get out of the way. He's just kind of changing levels and using Ariel's forward momentum to grab a leg.
They're arm punches, aren't they, from Kamal? Not really putting his body weight into it, but they're heavy arms he's got, though.
Yeah, and Kamal has to be very careful here because if Ariel starts seeing that the pattern, that when I come forward with those punches, Kamal's kind of just changing his level, he may be able to come forward and throw an uppercut and connect the button because, you know, people tend to be repetitive in their motions. What you do when you're tired or how you set your punches up. You look at the total strikes thrown throughout the fight. Ariel Sexton, 104 busier than Kamal Shalorus, who has 85.
Previous stats showed us that Shalorus had landed more, though, so he's obviously wasting quite a number of punches.
Now, if you take a look at the actual strikes landed, like you said, Kamal Shalorus, 37. Ariel Sexton, 29 punches landed. That's a good double leg takedown. Ariel Sexton trying to work back into getting his feet on Kamal Shalorus' hips. He's been successful in pushing him away, getting him off. I think if I'm Kamal Shalorus right here, I just want to stay on the ground and just try to grind out Ariel Sexton. Used the cage there. That was beautiful.
Yeah, he was gripping with his toes.
This is that Mataleon we talked about. He's on his back now. This is going to be a dangerous position. Kamal Shalorus has to control the choking arm with two hands and try to explode into Ariel Sexton just like that. I don't know if I'd call that exploding. That was more of a methodical turn, but serves the same purpose.
These boys are tired, and you can't blame them. It's been a long battle. 45 seconds left for them.
And if you see some of these stats coming up on your screen to everybody watching around the world, the reason we're doing that too is to help you guys with the scoring system here. 1FC, we score the fights based on a total cumulative as opposed to round by round. So things like the most damage is the number one thing we score on. You can get 75 takedowns, but if you got your butt kicked the whole time, it doesn't do a whole lot. So being able to see how many strikes are landed, general ringmanship, who's controlling, the pace of the fight, the different exchanges. These are all little notches in the belt when the judges look to score the fight.
A fight which is about to be finished. 5 seconds or so left, and this one will go to the judges' scorecard.
Yeah, well, you see here, there were a lot of back and forth, and just missed with that crazy spinning back kick. But the thing that we look for, outside of damage, is who came the closest to finishing the fight with a near knockout or a near submission. And neither guy really was ever on crazy street with a crazy punch.
By a unanimous decision, from the red corner, the Prince of